In the form of representations from various civilizations, from various distant places, we are seeing a mini universe here. We are inside a small microcosmic structure, which in future should permeate into the macrocosmic structure, creating universal order, peace and harmony. And talking about civilization, civilization is second beautiful and lovely gift of God, the first being creation. The first gift given by God is creation. Creation shows the splendor of God's ability as well as his boundless mercy and affection on all of us. And the second thing that he has instigated is the civilization. That is the second work in theo-architectonics. So civilization is a God-given gift of four major components, which are known as hope, resources, tools and opportunities for development. So civilization, according to definition, there are three stages of the civilization which we call as mature, semi-mature and super-mature or hyper-mature. The mature stages of civilization, the first stage of civilization, what we call generally refinement, is moral supremacy or superiority, where we know how to control ourselves to be distinguishable from beasts, to have the real incorporated instincts of the divine bestowal, how to organize ourselves and to organize our fellow beings, the power to control oneself and to organize a group. That started with civilization. That is delegation, self-control, which are all nothing but the forms of moral supremacy. This is the first stage. And the second stage is what we call semi-stage of civilization or semi-maturity, in which the status of living is developed in the form of residence, transportation, then communication by means of gesticulations, signals, symptoms, emblems, language, script, etc., which we call samjna, sankeda, bhasha, lipi in Sanskrit. So this is also something. And then acquaintance with resources and tools. These are all semi-maturity in civilizations. The real hyper-maturity or the benchmark of a civilization is to understand, to care and concern for one's own fellow beings and to believe, submit and serve God. This is said to be the hallmark of civilization. So the civilization reaches its culmination whenever a person thinks about the fellow beings and their totalitarian development or collective survival, along with their thinking of the primary force for our survival, establishment and proceedings, that is the form of the ultimate or universal spirit, God, believing him, surrendering and service. So this is what we call the model of the society, which is the evolution in the forms of social, economical, political and spiritual. First the society developed. Then the expansion of the society that has passed in the exploration of resources for survival and betterment. Then this type of exploration has resulted in clash and conflicts in sharing of power and resources, which has created a political administrative system. In power sharing of governance, there has created lot of conflicts and misunderstandings and wars, the discriminations which are to be washed away by a totalitarian development of ultimate and immaculate consciousness in the form of spiritual awakening. This is somehow connected with the Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya and Shudrotpadana of our system, not being very much congenitally, but systematically, sociologically. It forms the social community, then the economic resources are balanced by the other community, then administration by community, then the spiritual upliftment by the ultimate community like that. It can also take the reverse order, like the spiritual system governs the, it should govern the administration. The administration should be proper to get proper healthy resources. Only proper distribution and accommodation of healthy resources create a healthy society. So this is how we have to understand. And it is also connected with the theories. There is a conflict theory as well as the integration theory of people like Dr. Elwin Service and Dr. Barrett and Dr. Markhan Freud. These people, they culminated a theory which is known as the theory of people who are known as gangsters and hunters, that band. Then the pastoral band, then the chiefdoms, and also the priesthood, clergy and other people. Now coming to the present point, what is the reason for construction of all of these forms in the form of seminars, conferences, symposia, get-together, research, analytical studies about civilization? that which has happened before thousands of years and that which is diminishing and obsolete, what is the reason for the revival? It is to reconstruct the society, to regain the same glory, because science is not the substitute, technology is not the substitute, and mere political unilateral development is not the substitute. Mere erudition or perspicacity or knowledge development and epistemological reach cannot be the substitute unless the person's mind setup and mutual reality and bondage and affinity, if they are not properly constructed, that can be brought only by civilization, because science and technology is never in the form or component or a compound of the so-called civilization, and we cannot include the science and civilization totally to be something parallel or coherent at all. We cannot even imagine. So regaining the glory and revival of this civilization is the only way for bringing back the glory of tranquility and prosperity, real tranquility and prosperity in the society. So we have to reconstruct. Everybody is now talking about the clash of civilizations. What will happen in the future because of various socio-political, religious, economical issues? What will happen to the society? Everybody is very much bothered about those things. Like there are a lot of writers like Oswald Spengler, then Arnold Toynbee, and Samuel Huntington, lots of people, they have researched on all of these things. They're concerned about the genesis, how they evolved through migration, trade, which is everything known to all of the other people, by invasions, how it is done. But regarding the contemporary thing, what to do? Number one, I've already told, technical development and scientific development is an additive or a supportive factor to already existing mind setup. If a person is constructive, the technical tool will be also constructive. It takes the shape of the mind setup of a person. So it is not reliable contemporary. Even we have to say that these developments are very much unilateral and dangerous, pernicious to the present mindset of theory of the society. Then what to do? Because of two major factors, we have to analyze the present mindset in two major divisions because of these two factors. Even those who are very much crude, they used to be customized by development. For example, even if I am bad, by means of domestication, like we are doing for animals, in domestication, the exposure to the society, exposure to society, mingling with people, then getting into transformation. The first thing is domestication by means of tuition and training. Second thing is transformation by exposure of the pains and pressures of the society. Third thing is realization, which is a divine bestowal. Even the crude barbarian civilizations, if they are properly exposed, if they want willingly to be exposed, they can be mesmerized, materialized, and they can, their levels can be minimized, and they can be also brought into the level of understanding things with softness, delicacy, and divinity. And even good people or cultured people, if they are exposed to adulteration, dilution in the traditional standards, we are also examples for that. Adulteration due to various cultural infusions and mixtures, and dilutions because of our traditional lineage, what we call vichinna. We want avichinna, uninterrupted lineage. Now we are in vichinna sthiti. That is, we are subjected to intrusion and breakdown. That is the second thing. And third thing is coercion. Due to some compulsions of the environmental situations, even good religions, good cultures, they are put into turmoil. So in order to bring a good order to all of these things, we have to think about the future. The ancient historians or civilization mechanics, they told there are three opportunities for the future. One is a barbarization. Second thing is conventional world system. Or third, or he will be died. That is not a proper report. It should say something specific. So we have to take a design and model, and we have to make the model to work for our desired and ambitious and prolonged goal of our life or the system or of our tradition. So we have to design a model that is known as triple C model. What is triple C model? The first C is collective survival. To get a collective survival, we have to have a composite task force value. To get a composite task force, we have to have a common merge. We cannot merge with all people. You must have a common merge. Somebody told today about increasing the quantitative strength. How to make common merge? It can be made only with people, those who are having three things. One is similarity. What is similarity? Homo heterogeneous, and heterogeneous. These things are similarity. Those who are like us and with us, they are homogeneous. Those who belong to our own tradition but different in some aspects, they are homo heterogeneous. Those who are different from us, they are practicing something which is similar and proximate to us, they are hetero homogeneous. Those who are totally different from us, they are heterogeneous. First, we have to start with homogeneous affinity, then homo heterogeneous affinity, then hetero homogeneous affinity. Then we can also embrace the heterogeneous people and create the quantitative strength. It is a proper way which has been given by our shastras, our tradition. unless we do these things with the similarity, and they must have two more qualities, compatibility and flexibility. There are three things: religions or civilizations, there are institutions and persons. There may be personal conflict, there may be institutional conflict, there may be religious conflict. In some areas, religion is better, but the institution is worse, or the person is worse too. In some areas, the person may be better, but the institution, religion, they are totally against us. So we have to see where it can be compatible, where persons are flexible, and we have to make the quantitative strength. Then, if we make persons, that is quantitative strength, if we make the integrity, that is qualitative strength, if you create resources of finance and wisdom, that is effective strength, if you make it in the society with youngsters and budding generations, that is executive strength. These are all the four pillar model which we are going to do for our society. And whatever the future we are going to face, we are going to have the same repetition of the reasons what we have been given by Dr. Gerard Diamond. He has given some research. Why the religions or civilizations have been put into declination? Number one, because of environmental conditions. Number two, climate changes, social conditions, inner and external violences, and social response of multivarious activities and factors acting on them. These are all the reasons. Now we are having same problems, similar problems, and even serious more problems. Now we have to face the same thing. And we have to go on a scientific research. Scientific research means we have to go for fiscal demographic studies, historical dynamics, social macrodynamic structure. Like that, we have to go for a scientific research and come for the contemporary level. Contemporary level, there are four statements which are there vociferously being shouted in all corners. Alliance between civilizations, dialogue between civilizations, and how to create a pluralistic society in harmony. And what is multiculturalism? It has been shouted by a lot of people. But that is mere enthusiasm or eyewash service. It is not being practically maintained because of three major forces which are governing a person's emotion. One is a spark, second is a spirit, third is a stock. If you have stocked something here for your program today, you will just vomit the stock and go away. The stock thing is a political announcement or just a state declaration. Those who are having a spirit, those who are having a spark, those who are having a spirit can enlighten thousands of people. Those who are having a spark, they can get enlightened. So this is more than the UN. Dialogue between civilizations, I could see, because I have been seeing here not stocks, but sharp, shrewd, soft, and spiritually potential, radial, brilliant, effulgent sparks, as well as the spirits I could see here. Certainly it will mature more than what the other associations have been claiming that they will do. And moreover, there are two problems in the society with the so-called admirers of Reformation. The first problem is they cannot create five things. One is impact. What is impact? If they talk with somebody, they can create some sort of methodology to fill their ears, not minds. That is influence. How far they can influence the members of the society, they cannot do that. Third thing is erudition, knowledge precision. They cannot do, because they can give only superficial survey, peripheral survey, prosaic survey, not intensive survey, perspicacious survey, clairvoyant survey, futuristic contemporary survey. They cannot give. They will give only peripheral thing or even prejudicial. Somebody told that regarding the Australian natives, somebody have made a book which was full of prejudicial view. Like that, they will have only prejudicial and anti-realistic or anti-veritable statements, far away from the reach of reality, eternity, and truth. So this is what we are going. So we want real erudition that the people, they don't have. They don't master the things and come. They just munch some things and just reveal the same things in the society. That is the third problem. Fourth thing, they are not reaching the grassroots. Lot of the people, those who are going to serve you, those who are suffering, those who make the mass of the society are not within this auditorium. How to make the grassroots? Number fifth, how to create an organizational hierarchy, not anarchy or monarchy, to create an organizational, mutually love-blended hierarchy to reach the society by means of organizers, well-wishers, and patrons. This system is not there even with UN. I believe that hopefully after a decade, we could see a mega transformation and mega renaissance in the society through such activities. This is the greatness that we are going to achieve. So this UN declaration, even they are not having these things. The second problem is, first I have told inability. The second problem is incongruity. What is incongruity? If something is not easily unitable, you must not try to unite it. If something is unitable, you have to unite it. So uniting things which are not unitable and not uniting things which are ready to unite is the problem of incongruity with the civilizations. You cannot unite things with all. Distant things are different from different things. Different things are different from distinct things. Distinct things are different from dangerous things. For example, milk and nectar, they are different from each other. Milk is different from nectar. Water is different from nectar. And ambrosia is distinct from nectar. Amrita is distinct from nectar. And poison is also different from water, but you must not say that it is different. it is dangerous. So milk is also different from water, poison is also different from water, nectar is also different from water, but the grades are different. So those who are readily acceptable, embraceable, those who crave, cry and call for unity and social development and global development to create a global village and to create a harmonious society, such people, they have to be searched and embraced. That thing was not there with these people, because of which we are getting all of these problems. And coming to the society, civilizations, falling of civilization, risings are totally inevitable, inescapable, because manifestation, consolidation, permeation, absorption, contribution, upgradation, modification, domination, these things are unavoidable in the development of any society or civilization. Our domination is also that is entirely different. There are four dominations. One is promulgative domination of missionaries, invasive domination of coercive religions, we are having benevolent domination. Fourth thing is a political or societal domination, where you have to embrace the religion or customs without which you cannot survive there, as if it is there in some countries. So these are all the various dominations. We have our own benevolent domination to penetrate into society. And there are five status of civilization now. One is fusion. So many religions, they have fused with other religions and they are not traceable. Second thing is fall, that which is in declination. Third thing is fragile, that religions which are endangered. Fourth is flourishing, like our religion. Fifth thing is forceful and ferocious religions which are there in domination. So we have to understand the mind setup and social setup along with our own setup. We have to understand both proponent as well as opponent. Proponent, his component, opponent and his component, then only we can have a real combat, real debate, without which we cannot do in the society something productive and long lasting. Apart from our speeches, we cannot contribute anything in executive service. So coming to the conclusive session, I want to say that it is a proper time, it is a proper topic, it is a proper methodology, everything is proper, and we have to work on the basis of what we have started now. And coming to the final session, in which I want to give some ideas, four or five ideas, how to proceed with according to my mind, my limited mind or caliber, I want to present it here. Number one, as the society is having different type of approach models, number one is liberalism, I don't want any religion. Conversion. Conversion is also of three types. Some people, they are averse to conversion. They don't want anybody to get inside their religion, like Zoroastrians. They are preserving chastity. Some people, they cannot sleep unless they convert a dozen of people per hour. And some people, they are so intolerant or so magnanimous that they cannot see an opponent in the pathway. Even a common pathway, they don't want to see such a person. So conversion is like that. Conversion is either not to allow a person, not to allow a person inside the religion, one. Not refraining from the process of continuously allowing or dragging the persons inside the religion, number two. Number three, it is a way in which no other person is tolerated in the society. This conversion. Liberalism means I don't want any religion. Chauvinism means extremism and fundamentalism. I want only my religion. Secularism is of two types. One, all religions are equal. Second is pseudo-secularism, in which there is unilateral concession and indulgence. That is in secularism. The fifth thing is our religion, that is altruistic idealism. I want to give 3 points. If you see somebody from any part of the world that I feel really, I talk from my heart. It is not by any preparation or by any, from any part of the world that I feel really, I talk from my heart. It is not by any preparation or by anything. If I see somebody here from some other religion or civilization or some other land, I feel like I'm seeing someone, our brother or sister or kith and kin, after several decades. Even if we meet somebody or go to some place, we feel that we have left that land before several decades and we are coming back to our native land. This is what we call the quality of a cosmopolitan citizen, supraja or vishwapraja. This is what we have to develop. Now the society is entirely different. Even wife, brothers and sisters are considered to be aliens now. That is the present society. I delivered in a lecture on life management, I quoted one statement. What is the present society model? I told, disown your parents, dispute with your brothers and sisters, divorce your wife and destroy your children. This is the present society model. So we have to develop such a relation, and for which, like Silk Route, you might have heard out of the history of study of nations, national development, trade and civilization, you might have read about Silk Route. Like that, if the whole world is Mother Earth, the breast of the Mother Earth is India, and the milk is the wisdom and love showered by our scriptures and acharyas. So like the silk route for trade, India is the milk route of knowledge and love to the world. So we are really proud of the land. and we must be establishing the pride by our action and collective contribution and responsibility, not by quotations, citations, writings and publications. That's what we want to do. So number one, we have to create an optimistic model to include everybody. Our model is optimistic. Only we can do that because we have tolerance, we have mercy, we have love, we have choices for other people. You can do this or that. We are offering choices to people and we are happy with a lot of these people. That is our creator. So we are having optimistic model. Other models are known as obstinate models. There are three theories. One is supremacy theory. I am the greatest. Second thing is origination theory. This religion is the mother of everybody. The third thing is soul savior. This is the only religion. So these things are also some obstinate theories. Forgetting which, if we frame a real model that we are the embracer of everybody, certainly we can contribute lot of things to the society. In Bhagavad Gita, I want to quote a very small verse. Krishna says, Yoyo yam thanum bhadha, shraddhayarchitam icchati, tasya tasya achala shraddham, tameva vidadhamyaham. Which other god can say in the world that, oh Arjuna, I only establish different religions and different forms of worship as per the tri-modular adaptability of Sattvika, Rajasa and Tamasa, goodness, passion and ignorance. As per their tradition, as per the vasanas or the imprints, they are selecting the mode of worship and I instill the faith on them, gradually read in the ladder. I am leading them in the ladder of attaining liberation and attaining me. How great the tolerance, how embracing everybody, how giving opportunity to others, that is the greatness of our religion. So our model is known as second choice model. What is first choice? To be strong in your religion and to create the same staunchness for your followers. First choice. Second choice, integrate all the other diminishing religions and cultures and to create an integrity, possible integrity and protective integrity with all civilizations of the world. This is our model. They told that they are going to start a research institute. We have to certainly do in the research institute by means of rural propagations, by means of pamphlets and discussions, and also technical propagation methodologies like discussion, Yahoo discussion groups we can make, e-learning we can make, teleconferences we have to make. And certainly, coming to the final, really final point, the opponents, they are having power. Somebody having the power as well as a negative mind setup, they can create discriminations and destruction in the society and perennial fear. For that, we must be also qualified with the fiscal fist, the power of integrity, that is known as integrity match. Then knowledge match we have to develop, technical match we have to develop along with fiscal fist. I hope that I want to serve this institution by becoming a life pattern. I also advise my followers and believers to be life patterns for this association, to create a chain of mutual link, integral link in the society to create manpower, mind power and money power. We can achieve these things world, and I am very happy that along with the other people in the traditional robes representing various civilizations, I think that I am the only person in the Vedic traditional robe here. I am very proud and happy to be so. I wish the function a very grand success, and I also wish the function to create as many impacts as possible than the previous disasters of the earth. Let it be a beneficial and salubrious disaster to the society, bringing renaissance. Narayan, Narayan, Narayan.